Yes, so here next topic, that is your beta cumulative frequency step polygon. Okay, so let's see that what's our essential and what's our important over here in this topic. Very quickly, that I would like to explain each and everything, because I explained that frequency, cumulative frequency, and all the other type of things. Okay, then they are saying that drawing cumulative frequency step polygon. Hold on, let me check that quickly. Okay. So suppose okay, Kevin recorded how many times of the junk mails her parents get every day, and how many items of the personal mail. Okay, here are her result. Okay, so here beta, you are seeing that the number of items are given, junk mail that is given, personal mail is also given. So here junk mail and personal mail, they are given the frequency. Okay, and then okay, so cumulative frequency with respect to junk mail, that you have to write there. Okay, I think that very quickly that we can do that. So junk mail, so first one that you have to copy as it is, that is 6 and 9 6 15, and then 16 26 it will be, and at 28 and 48 it will be, and 7 it will be, 55 it will be, and then it will be 60. Okay, I hope that total 60. So that means here what you are getting that at the last, you know, with respect to cumulative frequency. So here they are saying that complete the cumulative frequency table, find the median number of junk letter. So there are 60, means here you are getting that 60 last. Okay, so it's a half, that will be 30. Okay, 30.5. So 30.5, that means it will be 3 letters. Okay, 30.5 beta, it is greater than 26. So that means we have to choose 3. Okay, understand? Just before I explain that to you, just before. Yeah, and then when you click that, yep, that's right. Understand? Yeah, it is perfection, beta. Yes, when you'll understand that one, when you'll see your all of videos, so your previous videos that you would like to revise all the topics which I'll explain that to you, and upcoming classes, beta, you have to understand all that which I'm explaining now. Okay, so here you can see that now very quickly that you can do that with respect to junk mail, that I calculated that median, and in the same way. So you can see that cumulative frequency that you get here, so 0.6 beta point, if you want to get the graph of that one, so you can see that number of item and their cumulative frequency combinedly, that will be as order pair. Okay, yes, so here you can see that the first point, that will be 0.6 is 0.6, a little bit it will be over here, maybe, yep, 1.15. So 1.15, that means 1 is here, and I think 15 will be, yep, here, and then 2.26, 2 is here, but and 26, that means a little bit, it is the half, almost over here and here, yep, and then 3.48. How we are taking 3.48? 3 is your number of item, 4 is your cumulative frequency, 48. Okay, so 3.48, that will be here, and 48 approximately it will be over here. Wait, yeah, here 3.48 and 4.55. So 4 is here, and 55, that will be over here, maybe, yep, yes, and 5.60. So 5 is at the last bit, and 60, that will be at the top. Yeah, so you can see here, so this is your cumulative frequency step polygon beta. Okay, you are seeing that a little bit stairs you are seeing. Okay, yeah, so that's why that it is known as cumulative frequency step polygons. Okay, so here step polygon you are seeing on your screen. Okay, so this type of that it isn't very often you see a step graph like this. Okay, why do you think that it's a line such as the blue one, okay, would be unsuitable for this data? So the main thing is they are saying that ki why if you would like to draw the line over there, why it is not suitable. So the answer is that this data is discrete, okay. That data is discrete. You can only have a whole number of junk letters, okay? Because that means it means that it is not possible to have that. Is it possible that I would like to send you that 2.5 mail?
No.
Yeah.
It cannot be continuous.
Yeah. So that means it is a discrete.
Mm-hmm.
Discrete. So that means, or you can simply understand that it's a quantized data. Okay, quantized. That means you can send as a whole, okay, not in fraction or not in decimal, okay. Yes, so in this way, yep. So the blue line would suggest that there are 37 days, okay, where you receive 2.5 letter, okay. There are 37 days, this dotted line you are seeing, okay, when you are receiving 2.5 letters, okay, sorry, 2.5 mails. Okay, and then there were only 26 days when that happened. Okay, 26 days when that happened. So 26 that you are getting here. Okay, because from 26 it is jumping up to 46, 47. Okay, so in between that there is nothing. But if they are asking that any regarding a question. So that means at 2.5, how many days will be there? So 37 that you have to draw a perpendicular line, okay? And then you have to draw a parallel line with respect to x-axis where it will meet on y-axis. That will be your answer. So here you can see that approximately it will be 37. So 37, that will be your answer. Clear? Now, come to the next one. So next here, beta, a cumulative frequency graph can be thought of as a less than graph, okay? Less than graph, okay? So, less than graph, okay? So here, Kavinas present got 0 item or less of junk mail on 6 days, okay? Yeah, you can see that?
Mm-hmm.
0 or less than, okay, of junk mail on 6 days, okay? And 1 or less than on 15 or like this, okay? All the data that you are seeing here, also 1 item or less item on 15 days, 2 or less item on 27 days, okay? 3 or less than, that you are getting that 48 or 50, and then 4, that will be approximately 55, and 5 or less, that will be of 60 or 58, okay? So in this way that you can see that, yeah, you are seeing that? Yes, all these data, okay? Yeah, so here.
So it is easy.
Yes, it's easy. So it is your less than data, okay? It's your less than data. Understand? That means 0 or less, 1 or less, 2 or less, 3 or less, 4 or less, 5 or less. Clear? Yeah. So in this type of, you will get that your less than graph. So I think that next one will be more than graph. Yes, it is your more than graph. Okay. So in more than graph, also we can find the median for the means more than graph. But here you can see that total frequency that you are getting 60. Okay. Do you remember that cumulative frequency at the last that I got 60 over there? Okay. So that means say you have to do half of that because it's an even number. So 60 divided by 2, then it will be 30. So if you'll, then 30 you have to mention over here. So I think 30 is here. So you have to make dotted line over 30 and then you have to get down. I think 3 will be your answer. Yes, 30 and then you have to get down. Oh yes, that's a 3. Okay. So that means out of 30, okay, you will get 3 items. Okay, that means 3 mails that you have to send in. Yeah, 3 items that you have to send junk mail per day, okay? Do you understand it?
Sir, can we go back, sir? Once, back slide?
Yeah, here, yep. It's a less than data.
No, second slide, I guess.
Okay, second we can move, yes, here. Means you think that, yeah, okay, I understand that what you mean to. Get back, you can see that 60 is here, beta. 60. Okay, cumulative frequency, last one that I told you that whatever at the last will be there, that will be also the number of person or number of male, number of data, you know. Explain that or not? And also explain that suppose that number of terms are given. So if the same number of terms that you will also get that your cumulative frequency at the last. So then you have to consider that you are getting right. So but here you are seeing that no number of total persons as are given here. So what you have to do? So just to find out the total number of persons, you just have to see of your last cumulative frequency. So you are getting here 60.
So we have to take n plus 1 by 2, na, sir, in this case? This is even. No, n by 2 plus n plus 1 by 2, that formula.
Oh yes, yes, but that's the same thing, n by 2 or n by 2 plus 1. So that means 30.5, wait, 30, yeah, 30.5 that you will get, okay. So 30.5, beta, 30.5, you can see that it is greater than 26, but less than 48.
Less than 40.
Clearly understand that your answer will be 3 item, okay.
3, yes sir, yes sir.
Understand? Great. Yes, so here 30. So 30 exactly, beta. They are not doing half of that one. Means simple with respect to cumulative frequency. They are dividing that half. So that's why that up to 30, that if you'd like to do that, then you will get that over there 3. Yes, like this. Again, I am explaining. And then downwards. Yeah. So it is your answer. So that means this data has a median value of 3 item. Of chunk meal per day. Again, yes, next is also beta, work out for the cumulative frequency of the Kavina's parents' personal mail. Okay, wait, very quickly that I have to do that. Give me 1 second. First one will be the same. Here will be 19, here will be 27, and then 37 it will be. And then it will be 40, 50 it will be, and then 50, 60, 61 will be, okay. That means there are total 61 person, okay. So 61 is your odd number. So 61 is your odd, so it, you have to do that 61 plus 1, 62 by 2, that means 31, okay. So 31, that means in that condition also you will get 3 number of item there, okay. And you will mark it. Oops. Sorry. What I did wrong there? Oh my god. 19 plus 7 will be 26. Oh my god. Actually, it's another student line. That's why I am a little bit hurry. Wait. 26. Sorry. 36. Sorry, beta. Yes, 36, it will be, I think, 49, 1 will be less, 40, it will be 50, no, 49.
36 plus 13.
Yeah, and it will be, yes, I think 60 it will be, yes. Oh.
49, then 60.
What is happening? Yeah, it will be 60. Yep. And then you'll mark it. Yes, that's right. Now, you have to mention the points. So, points 0,8 will be with respect to number of item, and 0,8 it will be approximately over here. And 1,19 is here. 19 that will be approximately over here. 2,26 that will be 2 is here. 26 I think a little bit over here. Yep. 3,36, 3 is here, and 36, so that will be 30, 35, a little bit will be here, yes, and 49, 4 is here, and a little bit downwards it will be, yeah, and 5 and 60, so 5 will be here, and the 60 will be at the top, yes, that's right. Okay, so you can see that. So what is the median of this data? So 100% beta, 60 plus 1, that is 30.5 is also between there. So here you will get that 3 letters again. And if we'll do that, yep, that's right. Clear? Do you understand that?
Yes sir.
Great. So I think that after this one, what we have to do. Oh, yes. Suppose that it's the total. Okay. They are saying that 60. Okay. 60 is here. Mm-hmm. 60 half, that will be 30. Okay. Just 30. Mm-hmm. You can see that I am getting down. Oh. What? Yeah. 30.
It will be in 3, I guess. Three.
Yes, exactly. That is coming 3. Yep. Yes, you can see that. Here, it is 3. Okay. So, 30, 3. Understand?
Mm.
Yeah. So, in this way, that anywhere, any data that will be given, like 40, like 45, anywhere. So, by this way that you can increase or decrease. And whatever amount that they are asking, you can do regarding to that. So here they are asking 30, 60, 60 plus 1, so it will be 30. So regarding to 30, you can see clearly that it will be here, okay?
Okay, sir.
Understand? So, beta, I'll upload your this video also within 1 hour that you will be able to see, okay? Almost other videos also, I would like to upload that. All the videos which will be of 1 hour class, that will take a little bit time. Means approximately you can understand that within 2 or 3 hours or all the videos that will be on my channel. Okay. So thanks a lot. Okay, have a great time and greetings to your parents. Thank you. Bye-bye.
Thank you, sir.